Hello viewers, and welcome to yet another World of Tanks special. And first of all, I would like to point out something good that just happened. I now have a 10th subscriber, so thank you very much to Goldrings of the Cirse clan. And he also gave me a very good piece of advice on my recording. He did bring up to the attention that there was a lot of white noise in the background because my microphone was really quite loud. I have addressed that. I'll just turn the volume down a bit. I have addressed that. So hopefully now there will be limited or even no white noise at all, which should improve the quality of the video drastically. Now then, I'm driving the KV-1S here, tier 5, not tier 6, heavy tank of the Soviet Union on Arctic region, and that Lukes on the enemy team has already called his team a noob team, and he's not going to stop there. There he is. He's going to get killed in a minute. Watch his reaction in chat. Quite what he's so confident about, I'm not sure. You watch when our bishop takes him out. Ooh, Chinookai. Alright, we'll have a go. One in. Two in. Bishop has just taken out the Lukes. I take out the Chinookai. Watch the reaction of the Lukes in chat. Bishop, you lose your account forever, cheater. Have nice bands. See you bye-bye for last time. I think this Lukes really is taking it too far. Yes, it's a bishop, but he hit a very, very softly armoured target and destroyed it. What's so cheat-like about that? Anyway, casually destroyed a Churchill Mark I where he wasn't looking there. And doesn't look like there's anything else coming down this way, so might as well advance. And hopefully... Look, he's still going, let's see ya. hopefully I'm going to get some flanking shots on these two enemy heavy tanks. By the way, XVM rated this game as a 59% chance to win. We've just lost our M7 and it's now down to 49%. Because, you know, reasons. There's the KV-1S. Put one into the back of his turret and then KV-1 finishes him off. There's the KV-1. Put one into him. And he has no idea that I'm behind him. Put another one in. And finish him off with a third shot. He clearly was not paying attention. Now then, who's next? Birchgun? Oh no, Panzer IV Asfay first. Alright. Well, there's one. Leaves him on 5 health. Birchgun damages my gun. Managed to take out the Panzer IV Asfay while on the move with the damaged gun. And then I repair the gun and turn my attention to the birch gun. Put one in, but then notice there's a Panzer SFL-4C, so put one shot in. Lukes takes out the birch gun, and I finish off the Panzer SFL-4C. Oh, and now there's a Panzer SFL-4B. I really wish some of these vehicles in World of Tanks didn't have such complicated names, so it doesn't take you an age to say, to, you know, just to say them. One shot into the Panzer SFL-4B and ramming takes him out, which means there's only Churchill Mark I left on the enemy team. And he is all the way over the other side. I am not going to get any more out of this game, but I don't necessarily want any more out of this game. Managed to get Mastery Badge Ace Tanker, Pfeiffer Effect, High Caliber, Top Gun, and 1,105 base experience earned, which is brought up to 3,314 with premium account and the first victory of the day bonus. 164 free experience and 37,556 credits profit. And that was a pretty good game in the KV1S. But that was just a starter. Let's now move on to the main events. This special, by the way, will very much be a spill-based special, apart from the first and last replays, which are my own. All the other ones were sent in from Spill. Here's the first. He's driving the VK2801 Tier 6 German light tank on Muravanka. And as usual with all the replays sent in by Spill, he's driving a vehicle that I've never driven before. So I really can't tell you anything about it in World of Tanks. I can't give you my opinion. I can't really summarize it, because I don't really know what it's like. Now then, XVM. Must turn the volume down again. Sorry about that. XVM rates this as a 58% chance to win. He's moving over to the west side of the map. Looks like he's going to go onto this hill, try and get some early spots for his team. The reason why I'd ever driven this is because it's a light tank that is beyond Tier 2 that isn't the BT-7. Why, you ask? Well, light tanks really aren't my thing. You see, you have to have much more skill when driving light tanks, I feel, in World of Tanks, because you have to take moments, good moments, as they come. And I don't think I have the kind of reactions that you need to realise precisely what time is the right time to make a move and make a difference for your team. And if you don't take that opportunity, then another one will probably not come up again, and that might cost you your life, or it might even cost the team a victory. Now then, there's an IS-3 there. He's mounting the sort of howitzer-like gun on the VK2801. He's using mostly high explosive shells, and that was exactly the right kind of shell to use against the front of an IS-3. I mean, he does have armor-piercing and high-explosive anti-tank, but armor-piercing would never have penetrated the IS-3 from the front, and high-explosive anti-tank is not a reliable penetration against the front of an IS-3. Ooh, there's a T-37, though, which is much easier to penetrate with high-explosive. What is the damage of this gun? It's 410, so... Ooh, managed to hit the Panther there. I think it's a Panther. Yep, it is. He was actually aiming for the Tiger and managed to hit the Panther. Still, not going to complain. What's that over there? Oh, it's the IS-3 again. Can't really get a shot. Nah, he's been taken out anyway. There's an IS and a Black Prince over there. What's Spilgen doing now? Something good must happen soon. Because I can see the results screen on my other monitor, and it was definitely a good game. I suppose just haven't seen any of it yet. Coming over to join his allies over here. What's that? Oh, there's an IS. Alright. 172 damage. And pull back to reload. Friendly KV-4 is chasing down this Black Prince. Gets a fair bit of ramming damage, actually. Switches to high explosive anti-tank there to deal with that Black Prince. Absolutely the right thing to do. Still have that loaded and bounces off the IS. Yeah, not really very reliable against a Joseph Stalin tank. We could do with high explosive for this, Bill. Did I say high explosive? I meant armor piercing. Oh well. High explosive anti-tank shell did the job that time. And it got him the kill. What next? Ooh, artillery. Can't see him. Damn. Alright. Well, the other side of the map has now been lost. The forest to the east is entirely in enemy hands. What's that? It's a T-20. You don't see a lot of T-20s around anymore. Bit of damage with a high explosive. Don't know where that shot went. Takes a blind shot. Looks like it hit nothing. Still nothing really spectacular happened yet. What's that? Oh, that's the T-20 again. And that missed. Weirdly. That one didn't, though. What's that? Oh, that's the AMX M445. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Very thin armour on the side of the AMX M445. Managed to get a penetration, and looks like I managed to get another one. Finishes him off. Side of the T-20. Fair bit of damage. Oh, rear of the T-20. Oh well. Good fair bit of damage. He's on very low health. And even still, doesn't manage to kill him. And now he's out of high explosive. So he switches to last remaining shells of his high explosive anti-tank to deal with this super Pershing. Yeah, spaced arm on the front of that turret. Oh, that's the end of the game. Well, amazingly, he managed to get Marshal Badge Ace Tanker out of that. Fire for effect, Bruiser, and Confederate. He managed to do 2,334 damage, 1,203 base experience, making for a total of 2,345 experience plus 93 experience and 19,335 credits profit. Despite the fact that he had to fire 5 of his high explosive anti-tank rounds during that game. So, without further ado, let's move on to the next replay. And here we are. Spill is now driving the WZ-131 Chinese TS-7 light tank, and he is in fact platooned up with Deadman, who is driving the same vehicle. And we're on Fjords, which I believe is a Norwegian setting. Don't ask me how I know that. So, let's see what he can do here. He's saying he's going to the waterhole, which I assume means the centre of the map, around the sort of F5 area. I assume that's what he means by the waterhole, the little pond thing there. I think Deadman's going to join him. You can see him there. Yep, they both love their light tanks. Looks like they're now going to compare reloads. Oh, careful. Don't want to damage each other. Oh, and there's an enemy. What is that? T-37. Ooh. Tiger from behind. Manages to bounce off dead man. They're harassing this tiger now. Yeah. Not very good elevation angles on Chinese vehicles, unfortunately. Certainly not downwards. And that is that a Leopard prototype? Yeah, it is. Bounces the killing shot. And then T-37 misses. You see, I couldn't do this. I couldn't poke up and down like this, and it's all going. The ground in front of me is all going too fast for my liking. Still, he's managing to make it work for himself, and he's got himself a T-37 kill. There's another light tank over there. It's a bulldog. Looks like he's pointing this way. There's not any more. Not managing to hit this bulldog. Still, there's a very juicy side of a Yag Tiger there, which Spill manages to miss. Oh, he's going for the track. Doesn't penetrate. Got it that time though. You can just pin him in position like this and keep putting shot after shot in, and the Yag Tiger can't do anything. Oh, he's managed to repair the tracks, but it's too late. He's got enemies to the side, enemies in front, not a chance. Now then, there's only four enemy tanks left. Looks like they're all at the south, so it's time for some flanking time. Quite what two light tanks are doing over there, I don't know. Any guess is as good as any. Speaking of which, oh, that's a T-49, you don't want to get hit by that, Spill. Manages to take out the T-49. IS-3 and VK-4502A left. Not got great deal of health left, either of them. Well, the VK is dead, just the IS-3. Manages to put a shot in before the T-54 rams him to death. And that was another Mastery Badge Ace Tanker game. From Spill there, Fire for Effect and Bruiser as well. He managed to do 2,789 damage. 1,394 base experience, that's really quite a lot. 4,182 after you take into account the first victory of the day and premium account. 206 free experience, 42,712 credits profit. You can't get much better than that on a good day's work. Moving on now to Tier 8. Spill is now driving the 112, or 112, or 112, or whatever you want to call it. Quite why the Chinese named some of their vehicles just after numbers, I don't know, but, you know, Chinese. It's a Tier 8 premium Chinese Tier 8 heavy tank. So, I have this as well, and I can tell you that I absolutely hate this vehicle, but that's not a very good analysis of it, so that's all I'm going to say. Let's see whether Spill likes it or not. We're on Pearl River this time, and he is on his own. He's not platooned with Deadman. And the friendly Kyonovan manages to drive into him. You know, that's what World of Tanks is like. Anyway, looks like it's going to go over to the traditional heavy tank exchanging fireplace in Pearl River. That's very badly worded. There's an MX-1390 that's gone ahead on a little scout. He's not found anything, so he... Is he coming up? Where's he going? Oh no, he's continuing down this flank. Now then. Oh, what's that? It's an E-75. In case you're wondering how I'm managing to tell what these vehicles are, I'm looking on the minimap. Although I do appreciate it is quite small. That's why I'm telling you what they are. Quite a bit of drama breaking out in chat, looks like. Oh god, why does this happen? Because World of Tanks, that's why. There's a whole bunch of enemy tanks over in the center here. Oh, there's a bulldog, and he's not paying any attention at all. In fact, there must be something else there, because he's just managed to lose some health driving backwards. Oh look, it's a Lerva. Now, Spill misses, but takes a shot from the Lerva, so he backs off. Artillery is attacking the Lerva. Now he puts a good shot into the Lerva and denies a return shot. Artillery manages to hit the Lerva. Looks like he was going for a rushed cupola shot that missed, but looks like something else hit him. Probably artillery again. Notices that this Panther is in trouble. Looks like he's going to help him out. It's an enemy 112, that. And blows up the ammo rack. Classy. Now there's an IS. Misses, but artillery gets some splash damage. Got some really good artillery on Spill's team. What does XVM think of this? Pretty even. Puts one into the IS while the IS was distracted by the artillery arc. He was not going to reload in time to get a shot at Spill, so IS has been taken out. Now the Lerva is still alive. Doesn't look like he's there anymore though. Where could he be? Panther hasn't managed to find him. Oh, there he is. He's down there. And there's a Waffenträger Panzer IV here. The Lerva's been taken out. Yep, Waffenträger Panzer IV executes him. Coming down off this slope. Bit surprised that didn't take off his tracks, to be honest. Came down a bit sideways. What's that? It's an SU-152. No problem for 112. It's just the enemy artillery left now. Enemy M53 M55 manages to shotgun the T-54 over there. Kills the Lorraine 155-51. two left. There's the GW Panzer. Oh. Leaves him on the fraction of health. Rams him to death. Problem solved. Just one left now. M53, M55. Oh, received a hit there. SU-100M1 takes out the M53, M55. And that was, once again, Mastery Badge Ace Tanker. Demolition Expert, that was the blowing up of the Amarak of the enemy 112. Fire for Effect, Spotter, Bruiser, Top Gun. He managed to do 3,275 damage, 1,399 base experience. Again, absolutely fantastic. 2,307 experience in total, and 103 free experience, and 99,708 credits profit. He was actually given 118,419, and because it doesn't cost that much to repair and resupply the ammunition on premium tanks, he managed to gain a profit of pretty much 100k. Yeah, turns out you can get much better than getting a Mastery Badge Ace Tanker in a WZ-131. He's getting a Mastery Badge Ace Tanker in a 112. So, let's move on now to the fifth replay of the special. And here we are. Spill is now in a Tier 9 vehicle, the T-54 Tier 9 Soviet medium tank, or one of them, the other one being the Object 430 version 2. He's on Kharkov. He does love his T-54, I do believe. He's had plenty of good games in it, and I do believe I have shown some of his T-54 replays before. Let's see what he can do this time. There's a very good WZ-132 player on the enemy team. I expect XVM's taken that into account. Yep, there's only a 34% chance to win for his team. Well, you can only do your best. Comes over to this center area here. Ooh, that's a VK-4502B. I wouldn't stay there too long, Spill. There's a couple of GW-100s on the enemy team. Still determined to spot some enemy vehicles as they come across, but... Ah, yeah. The real problem here is that none of Spill's team, none at all, have gone to the southeastern corner of the map. Equally, none have gone to the northwestern corner either. Which means all of Spill's team is concentrated in the centre of the map. Which is good in a way and bad in a way. He put a shot into that WZ-132, and a spectacular shot from the Jagdpanzer E-100 finished him off. There's the VK-4502B that he saw earlier. Massively well-armoured thing, that is. But looks like he's got his side. Nope, he blows the tracks off. The thing with this is... Yeah, turret cupola. Turret cupola, or if you're really desperate, turret cheeks. Don't aim for the lower glacis because it's almost as strong, literally almost as strong, as the upper glacis. It's managed to get another cupola shot. And another cupola shot. Humiliation is happening here. It's quite a heavy vehicle, you don't want to get rammed by that. I think he managed to get another cupola shot, and now he's got a shot into the side. He's got this guy. Without a doubt. Another shot. He's probably switched to high explosive for this last one. bounces the last one, but he bounces as well. Couldn't matter any less. Because that shot finished him off. And it turns out he was the only enemy vehicle on this side anyway. So, doesn't really matter that none of Spill's team came over here. Because there's no more enemy vehicles over here. Now then. He's getting tantalizingly close to the artillery park, which could be rather rewarding. But there was an IS-7 spotted still in the cap circle somewhere. There he is. Yep, he's AFK. Goes for the tracking shot. I'm really not sure that that's necessary, but why the hell not? That's two shots. And there's three shots. And there's four shots. And there's five shots. Does it really take this long to take down tier 10 heavy? And another one. Should only take one more. And it bounces. Why? Well, World of Tanks, that's why. Finishes him off with that shot though. And there's one of the GW100s, and he's missed. Not much of the GW100 to shoot at from here though. Managed to get a good shot there. There's no way he's going to manage to reload by the time Spill gets around here and finishes him off. And there we are. One artillery down, one artillery to go. He's just got to find him first. And there he is. And he's missed as well. Absolutely perfect. One shot in, two shots in. GW100's taken out. Now there's just a single IS-7 left on the enemy team. He's got all sorts of trouble from all these friendly heavy tanks. Doesn't look like Spill's going to get the kill. Just missed it. Still, that was once again a mastery by Jay's tanker. Spill does have a habit of sending me replays that have him earn a Mastery Badge Ace Tanker badge. Of course, you know, fair enough. Of course, if they're Mastery Badge Ace Tanker games, they will be good games. He also got Fighter, Fire for Effect and Bruiser in that one. Managed to do 5,515 damage. 1,437 base experience. Again, absolutely fantastic. 2,155 in total with 106 free experience. And 46,500 credits earned as profit, just over. So, that's enough of Spill. Let's move on to the last one and get back to my own replays. And here we are. I'm driving the 121 Chinese Tier 10 medium tank on Windstorm. I love the 121. Absolutely fantastic thing. It's one of my top 10 vehicles, most definitely. In fact, one of my top 5 vehicles, I'm pretty sure. Now then, strange reference by the STA-1 there. The good, the bad, and the weird. Oh, by the way, some of you may realise that I'm not able to show you the post-battle results screens. That's because my recording software, for some reason, won't record anything that's on a web browser. Which is why I have to just tell you at the end of the battle all the kind of credits earned and experience earned and all that kind of stuff. I was hoping I'd be able to fix the issue somehow, but it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to. Or, if I will, it'll be needlessly complicated. So I have to deal with this. Nice AMX 1390 there, so put one in. Oh, there's an IS-8. So, I miss. Now then, the AMX 1390 is now dead. I'm going to go around here. I narrowly miss a shot from, I presume it was the IS-8. Come around here, and there's another IS-8. There's one shot. Deny him a shot back. There's a T-49 over there. Good thing with my replays is that, you see, in-game I like to have my mini-map quite large, much larger than Spill has it, so you'll be able to see what the enemy vehicles are much more easily. Waiting for this T-49 to come around. If he is. Yep, he is. He is that stupid. Alright. I'm not going to complain. Gets me a kill. Oh, E75. Yep, shot in, and then M103 takes him out. Lovely stuff. Now then, that enemy IS-8 is getting surrounded. Can I put him out of his misery? Yep. There we are. Another kill. Come up now and help my allies up here, but first there's a T-54E1, so I might as well deal with him. Alright, one shot in and E-100 finishes him off. Still haven't taken any damage yet. Finish off that T-54, and now there is an Object 704 behind this rock. He's been tracked, I put one in. Oh, there's artillery. Oh, I miss, and now I've taken damage. Shot from artillery there. There's a T-49, but I miss. I take a hit from that T-54. Waiting for the T-49 to come back over. Can't see him. I've got to be careful now. Preserve my health. Thanks to the enemy Object 261, who has just shotgunned an attacking M103. Oh, E50 Ausfeld. I bounce, and he manages to get a shot into me. Yep, we can get a shot in him that time without him getting a shot at me. There's an IS-8 down there. There he is. I put a shot in. And another one, and he's turning the gun round. And he manages to take me out. Still, wasn't a bad game. Yeah, it was only Master Badge 2nd class, but I did still manage to get high caliber and fighter effect as well. I did in total 4,476 damage, 907 base experience, which is, you know, it's not bad. 2,720 in total with 134 free experience, and a total of 26,158 credits profit. So, you know, not bad. And this game does end in a victory. Just going to take a while for them to find the Object 261. While they're doing that, I'd like to say once again thank you to my 10th subscriber, Goldrings of the Cirrus Clan, who also gave me plenty of advice on how to improve the quality of my videos. And hopefully, all you viewers out there enjoyed watching this, all of these replays. Not sure how long this this special is going to be. If it's over an hour long, I apologise. There we go, they've found the Object 261 and they've killed him. As always, viewers, good luck on the battlefield, and I'll see you next time.